Flow Designer enables you to create a flow to automate various actions and processes. When integrating with a third-party application, you can create connections at the main flow level, the action level, and the subflow level, and override them when needed. Now let's see how Ravi builds a flow with multiple connections for an integration with Docker, a third-party software application. Before building the flow, you must configure more than one connection record for the application in the Flow Designer Connections tab. Here he's set up three connection records for Docker. Now he's ready to create a flow. He starts by opening Flow Designer and selecting the Docker Spoke application. He enters a name for the flow and selects the application. In this case, the Docker Spoke he configured is already selected, and the flow structure is created. Now he needs to make the connection options accessible in the flow so he can configure them. To do this, he selects the More Actions button, opens User Preferences, and enables Show Advanced Connection Options. Back in the flow, he adds a trigger to go off daily at a specific time. Now he adds a subflow to start when the trigger goes off. Here, he selects the Docker Webhook subflow. He copies and pastes the payload and image webhook code from the container record into the form fields and saves it. Now let's see how Ravi can configure connections at the flow level and the subflow level. The trigger is at the flow level, so when he selects it, opens the More Actions menu, and selects Configure Connections, he sees that Use Default Connection is selected for the flow. Subflows inherit the connection set for the flow. Ravi checks the subflow connection, and it's also set to the default Docker connection. Now he sets up an action after the subflow. Upon filling in the required field for this action, he opens Advanced Options to configure a connection. Now he creates the last action in this flow for lookup containers. For this action, he selects a different connection. And finally, he saves the flow. Ravi can override any of these connections. To override the connection at the flow level, Ravi selects the trigger and chooses a different connection. When he selects the subflow, he verifies that the connection record is overwritten. It inherited the updated connection record from the flow. And he can override the connections configured for actions as well. We've seen how to create multiple connections within a flow, allowing you to connect to different environments from a single provider. To learn more, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.